children always amaze us and say things we don't expect them to say, but when they say, it's not profound. Joachim, when asked what saying it was, he said, something that came from heaven and is on the earth. Well, that, I think, sums up what I would have said this morning. So, on that note, we will go to page 100. Yes, we today observe All Saints Sunday as we celebrate the lives of the saints, so called by the church. And we tend to conclude that we are speaking about persons long dead and who are revered for their holy lives. Well, if you were to check them out, all of them, none of them would stand the test of perfection. That, I think, is instructive. Because that's the point of the saint in life. To be able to live through all that life has to offer and remain standing tall. So we at the church, all of us, whether you think so or not, are saints. We are holy people because we read in the scriptures, in the story of creation, as the church, as the Israelites sought to explain how they came about, they came to the conclusion that if God made the world, surely, and if God is good, it stands to reason that we are good. For in fact, they said that God said it was good. So, if there is a lie told, then God told a lie, because we are good. So we are saints. Saints, holy, we claim to be a part of this holy institution called the church, a worldwide body of believers who strive to live a life worthy of the gospel. We speak of being blessed by God's Holy Spirit, and that Spirit in many ways infuses our lives, and we express that in so many and varied ways. Surely we are holy in that regard. But I want to suggest to you that there is a lot more to it than just that. Because the saint is not one who just relies on the fact that someone says that she is holy because God made her. He is the saying, live out that life in ways that do define what the saintly life is. For in the first instance, we seek to serve the world. When we look at ourselves in the mirror every morning, not just to admire how good looking we may be, but ask ourselves, what's the point of my being here on this earth? I'm sure we all feel that there's a purpose in my life, or we ought to feel that way, and that purpose is to make life for others meaningful. So we serve in some way or other. It could be in our work as a teacher or an accountant or a lawyer or a farmer or whatever we are for ourselves. We serve, we provide for the well-being of people, of nations, of family. We offer ourselves for them to use it and use us for good. And in serving them, we are really serving God. Because it is God's will that we express our love for God and for others by being of service to them. Being of use in the world. So we serve. We seek to do things that really benefit our world for good. But more than that, we make ourselves available to God for God's service. When Israel was in a place where there was much trouble in the land and there was oppression, there was evil, there was much to destroy the human spirit, the prophet Isaiah was in the temple doing a holy thing, worshiping as we are here today. And we're told he saw the glory of the Lord in the incense that was being offered up. And he heard a voice say to him, Isaiah, my nation needs somebody to speak to it, to speak truth and life and purpose. My nation needs a voice that will take it in the right direction. Whom should I send? Who will go for me? And he said, what did he say? Here I am. Send me. I'm available to do something for good. Send me. When God looked upon the earth and saw the need to have someone present who could reflect the very essence of God, someone who could restore God's people as Messiah, Redeemer, he came to Mary, the young girl, and she heard this strange offer about her being the mother of Jesus. And she could not understand this nonsense. She said, I am not worthy. But she was told, yes, you are worthy. Just be available, Mary. And she said, let it be to me according to your word. She made herself available to be used by God in the service of God for God's love and God's purpose. So she was called to serve, he was called to serve, and they made themselves available. In doing so, they had to make an investment. Indeed, they had to make several investments. Investing of their time, investing of their passions, of their energy, of their will, of their talent, of all they had, they put it all in. It was like they were in Vegas, and it was at the table. I see what the play. Don't get it wrong. And they put all in. Every last chip is put all in the pot. No holding back. Be going to broke. That's what the saint does. Invest everything. Love with all your heart and soul and mind and strength and never as self. Invest everything because this is the purpose for which you were made and called. In service, in being available, you've got to offer something and you're offering yourselves. In all of that, the servant knows that she must say no to a lot of things that can detract or deflect or divert him or her from what they are called to do. You gotta say no to many things because they are not in line with the will of God. And in this morning service, as we baptize these four young people, baby and dumb children, you'll be asked three questions. Do you renounce? Do you renounce? Do you renounce? Are you prepared to say no to the things that destroy your will, the things that can keep you apart from God's love? Are you prepared to say no to these things? That's what the saying does. No. Because I have someone to whom I will say yes. So I say, called to serve, to make ourselves available, to invest ourselves fully in the work, to say no to a lot of things, we realize that we will meet many trials, many tribulations and temptations, but we've got to trust in God. We've got to trust in the one who said, I will never leave you, nor will I forsake you. We trust God. The psalmist says, they who put their trust in the Lord shall be like Mount Zion. That whenever things arise in our life, in our spiritual journey as Christians, as God's children, we recognize that, you know what? I got this. Because God got me. Think of the saints we have read about in scripture, in history, in our magazines. Think of them. The long, long ones who are in our stained glass windows and those more recent. Think of Dr. King. Think about Teresa. Of Desmond Tutu. Think of those people you know, that I know, who are living today, who have been serving, who are available, who are investing, who are saying no, who are trusting. My friends, can you spell? You're talking to saints. Serve, available, invest, no. Now, when you put that all together, there's no way you can look at your neighbor and tell him or her, you ain't no saint. Because they are doing just that. No matter what you may think of yourself, once you are serving, you are available, you are investing, you are saying no, you are trusting, you are saying, whatever you think of me, God knows I'm trying. From your own call to live that same life. So we today will bring into this community of saints Malia. She will not know what today is for her right now, but you, grandparents, must not know what it's all about. But she's a saint, even now. And she's become an even bigger and better one. And you, Finnegan, Rory, and Keegan, you don't understand what this is about. In fact, you asked that this be done. You wanted this for yourself. And that's important. You made that choice even at your tender age. So it's all good. We got your back too. We can do all we can to support you in this ministry. Your parents, grandparents, your uncle, your grandparents. They can make sure you learn what it means to be a Christian, Malia. And then we will be forever blessed having walked this journey. May God bless us as we bless each other in this wonderful call to love and serve God as God loves and serves us. Amen.
Amen.